Hey, welcome back. Thanks for joining me for another Magic Arena Cube Sealed. I've really been enjoying this format. It's so much fun. I remember being like, I don't know, a bit like anxious at trying this format out. Once I saw the list, I thought, oh, maybe it's not going to be that fun, but now I've played it, I've really, really enjoyed it. I've done a couple of them so far, 5-0 two of them, which is sweet. I'm just about to jump in and do another one, so yeah, come with me and let's see what we open. Let's take you through this one. Managed to fix the audio issues that we had on the last video as well, so I do once again apologise for those. We open our pack and let's see what have we got. Already I quite like the look of white here. White removal seems fantastic. Yeah, it looks great. Okay, start with the colours. We got Legion's Landing for doing token things, probably not though. Glass Casket, Seal Away, Banishing Light, all fantastic cards. Prison Realm, yeah, white removal seems strong. Elspeth Conquers Death, Cavalier of Dawn, nice bit of enchantment combo. We've got some dual land in white as well, some flyers, we've got Staggering Insight, Planar Cleansing, this Angel's pretty good too, Taranika, a Crone Veteran, seems okay. Yeah, white seems good. Let's see what else we've got. I think we're probably going to be playing white as a support colour though. Let's check out our blue. Okay, a few cards that I quite like here. Opt is always great. Stainful Stroke is usually pretty handy. I've been very impressed with Walkout Marauder. I think that's done a lot of work in the games I've played against it. I have not played it myself yet. Midnight Clock is the card that I really like. I don't know if it's actually good or not, but I certainly like it. Hippocamp's fine. Kefnet is cool, I like Kefnet. Spark Double seems quite good as well, depending on what else I have. Talaran's great. Sticking a Spark Double on Talaran seems cool, and I like Flunder Tears too. And again, those dual lands and those gold cards there seems great. Let's have a look at our black. Black we have some more interesting cards. Quick Breaker is cool. Cast Down, good bit of removal. Hippie, again, fantastic. Midnight Ripper seems okay as well. Erebos is quite good. Rankle is great, I like that card. Bolas Citadel is a card that I really love in some formats. I'm not sure how it will play out here though. Maybe we're not doing that. Command the Dreadhorde's an interesting one though. And then we've got Corpse Knight, which is good. Kunaros as well, a Hostage Taker, there's some good options in black there too. So look at our red. Yeah, we got a nice little one drop there, some burn spells, another okay one drop. Yeah, red seems fine, but I don't think I've really been impressed with red that much. Like Embercleave's cool, that's the card you want to have if you do a red-green aggressive deck or a red-white aggressive deck, definitely. But I don't think that's the deck that I want to play. Check out our green. There's some good cards. Tendershoot Dryad, I like that one. Gracious Hydra is good as well. A couple of Thorns. We would sort two for two. Plenty good green lands there. Rolesque. Interesting. Yeah, green seems okay, but again, I'm not really that interested in playing green. Colorless, we got Black Blade Reforged, which has done a non-zero amount of work in the decks I've played it in so far. Weatherlight's quite an interesting one. I don't think it's that playable here, but maybe we'll see. And Stone Cold Serpent is great. I definitely want to be playing that in whatever deck I'm playing. So I think we're going to make a choice. I think it just seems correct to play white. Maybe we'll try playing Esper. Yeah, let's start with white and see where we go from there. So, I definitely want to play Glass Casket, Seal Away, Banishing Light, Prison Realm, this Angel as well, this Elspeth Conquers Death, this has been very good when I played against it too, so we'll play that. Do we want to play Taranika? Indestructible 4-4 seems good. Maybe we're just doing that. Got some flyers. We'll try it. I like that one. This is cool. Kefnet, definitely. Spark Double, Talrand. Three more cards here. Probably Disdainful Stroke. Do I want to play stuff like Oft? So I can play Brambot Cutthroat maybe, or maybe this one. Taranika untaps. Yeah, Taranika plus Alurios seems interesting. But if we do black, what do we get then? Kunoros. Kunoros is a good one. We've got white black land and blue black land. Two cards, so we'd be splashing for Kunoros and do we want Corpse Knight or do we want Cast Down? We've got plenty of removal. Erebos? Do we want Rankle? Maybe we want a Rankle? Or Hostage Taker? Yeah, let's just play Hostage Taker. Seems good. Happy with our lands. 2, 3, 4 for 2 black pips. Yeah, I think I'm happy with this. Let's just jump right in. Let's go for it. Can't imagine it's going to take long to get paired here. Hasn't been at all while I've been playing these. Hasn't taken long. Who we got? We're playing against Chandra or Keikai. I'll go first. I like to see that. I've got all my lands. I've got some playables. We'll keep this, seems good. I'll lead on planes. My opponent got a swamp. They got a one drop. Nope. Okay, I will play an island here, and then we'll pass the turn. Probably just going to try and play this eagle, I think, next turn. Yep, that's fine. We've got plenty of ways to deal with that Lovestruck Beast. Yep, let's slam this eagle. You can get it with Glass Casket and hold up to Simple Stroke. Seems good. Yeah, seems good. I like that. Right. Start. The Glass Casket. And then we'll get into two in the air. Let's see if they play a spell across the ball. That'll be quite good. Oh, they did spawn a mayhem. Got him. Got him. Nice. In for one. And the race is on. Oh, that's great. It's just what I want to see. Another island there. And play God Eternal Kefnet. I feel like we're well ahead here now. Even if we've drawn off in next turn, we can play Warcat Marauder and Banishing Light to deal with whatever they play here. Stone Cold Serpent, nice. I'm not going to reveal this Talrand. Yeah, I think we just got to go for it. Just Banishing Light this. We'll get him for 7. Play this Marauder, and then that's presenting lethal. Nice and easy, hopefully. I'm sure they've got an abundance of cards I could have in black and green now. No, they said good game. Put them back with a good game to you. And there we go, round one taken down nice and easily. Yeah, I'm happy with that. That went very well. So let's just jump straight into round two. Ooh, we got a prize. Night Vale Predator. That was a cool card, man. I like that one. And here we go. Who will our mystery opponent be this time? It is still Liana, and it's Zanzibar. Yeah, we'll keep this. We got blue and black and a scry, and we can play the angel in three. This is good. Start off with that scry then. Starkman Insight. Sure, we'll keep that on top. We get to play that on the angel. I think that could be quite good. Some red-white. Might be a bit more of an aggressive deck, I thought, but no two drops. Probably got a lightning strike to kill this, though. No Mardu, okay. Shame Crackling Doom wasn't in the cube. That would have been quite good. That was a good card. Kouranos. Right, I think here, what do we want to do here? Just play this and then banish and light Kouranos. Yeah, we'll keep that seal away on top though. Do that. And we're going for three. Pacifism, that's a good one. Do I want to spark double this angel? Yeah, maybe. And then Stuck on Insight makes it 5-5, and I just start pumping out angels. Yeah, seems good. Seems good, Legion War Boss, sure. Block it, I hope they haven't got anything. No, they didn't. They did not. Staggering Insight here. Let's gain 5. It's Prison Realm with War Boss, I think. And this feels like a bit of a cakewalk again. Don't have any knights. But yeah, maybe. Yeah, seems a bit overkill, but yeah. There we go. Good game again, I think. I'm not sure what they could possibly have that would deal with this. They don't survive another turn, and yeah, sure. Another good game. Yeah, this deck's gas, I like this. And three. And our opponent straight away is Teferi, and it's Dadom. It's a bit of a slow hand, but maybe. When we hit a plains or a swamp from a scry. Regretting that keep already. There's a plains though, that's quite good. Play this one. Might be useful later on, let's just keep that to the top. I've got a feeling this might go quite long. Piper of the Swarm. Wow. They just mono black. Maybe they're just mono black. Yeah, let's keep that on top. Start drawing some lands. Yeah, I think they're just mono black. Maybe they're open to Gary. If Gary's in the cube. I don't know if Gary's in the cube. Seems like he should be. Oh, Swan Knight, okay. It's an interesting one. So it has to attack each turn, doesn't it? Let's prison on this. Next turn we're going to play a Hostage Taker. Turn after that we can play Cavalier of Dawn. Probably keep that. Yeah, they're definitely mono black. Ruin Raider, okay. Nice. Okay, so they are black blue. They're short on a colour. I think we'll just Hostage Taker this one. They're not playing this Merfolk anytime soon. They're gonna make some rats. Play this on my turn. Or we can play it in Midnight Clock. And a Resplendent Angel. Seems good. No attack. Find a Starbane Insight off the top, that would be nice, wouldn't it? Right. This Glass Casket we can definitely play. I think we'll play this one first. And then I think we exile this one. Getting three in the air. Trigger raid here, see what we draw. A land, fantastic. That's what we want to see. Merfolk Trickster is online. And it's gonna do what? Tap down Hostage Shaker? Sure. Do we want to trade? I think I'm buying. I'll play Tranquil Cove next turn and I'll gain life, so I'm missing no blocks. And I can activate this angel. Yeah. So I'll swing with the angel. I'm gonna say no blocks, we're gonna activate this angel. Gain 5, deal 5, make an angel, and then draw a card. Oof, we're gonna take 6, that's quite good. I guess I'm gonna block with this Rune Raider this time. How do I deal with a Demon Lord Bouncing Rock? I think I just want a Flood of Tears everything. yeah, we'll block a bunch of things here. Oh, that does the job too. We'll hit them with a little good game. That was sweet, that was the perfect top deck really, wasn't it? And then we'll get in with everything. Xaxes for 9. Fantastic. Yeah, this deck's sweet. In this deck, let's see how fast we can burst through this. 3-0 currently. Get 2 more wins, and that'll make me very happy. See who our opponent will be this round. It's not taking very long to find matches, which is good. I think this format's been quite popular. Playing against Jace or Han Solo with DDS. We'll keep this. We'll play a Danto Vanguard there. Try that again. We'll play a Danto Vanguard on turn 2 after we play Tranquil Cove. Take us a little while to work our way up to these cards. And they've got a Death Touch creature. Seems okay with this though, if I can pay life to do it indestructible. I'll take the one, that's fine. Nothing, okay, interesting. Interesting. Let's go swinging. Look, I'll pay four, I guess. Paying for is a little easier when you've gained that one life. Get rid of the Death Toucher, which is the important bit there. They didn't attack. Okay. Okay, what have they got? What do we do? Start swinging, I guess. Don't want to go to 13. Probably not. Probably not, but I do it anyway. Okay, they're going to exile that. That is fine. I'll play 3 life, get a Kefnet on board. I'm fine with that. That's cool. That's a good one. Agonized Remorse. Okay. Okay, interesting. Few options here. I don't think I'm winning this one now though. What are they going to take? Talrand. Interesting. Okay. I guess because that's the one I can play next turn. Decline to reveal that planes. But I will. So no attacks. Swing back, win a step back on defense and block this Knight of the Evil Legion here. And we'll put God Eternal Cabinet back on top of the library. Yeah, they're pumped. Possibly use their mana. We'll put this on top. Draw land. Any of our land, I guess, really. Right. Temple of Enlightenment. Can we bottom that? I I guess now they get to decide whether they're going to play something or just pump this knight. Pump the knight twice, okay. 8 to me. What is it correct to do here? Probably just... play my Phantom. Feels bad, but yeah, sure. So if they play anything big, we've got other ways to deal with that. Not play anything at all, okay. What will we try here? Try Kefnet. Sticks around. Put an egg. Draws them a card. They've got a lot of mana. They're not doing a lot with it though. No cards lighting up in their hands. Pop the egg for some mana. Nope. Maybe they thought they would draw a card from the egg. We're not going to reveal our planes. But we are just going to swing in. Something with flash, maybe? At night? Nothing, apparently. Thought Rager, cool. Get rid of Elspeth Conquers Death. So I guess they've got something with 5 CMC or more. About 3 CMC or more, even. Something big. Destiny Spinner, okay. That is fine. Doesn't do a lot here. Swinging with both. Disfigure. Okay. That's fine. Do we want to make a spark double of Kefnet? Yeah, probably. And they conceded, wow, okay. Sweet, happy with that. It's going well. Oh, very well. Yeah, we've got 4-0 so far. Let's run it back. Win this next one. Get some gems. And then that was a very easy 5-0. Very happy and impressed with this one. All coming together. Yeah, I don't think I'm a big fan of 3-colour or 4-colour decks. I think you have to have like Fires of Invention or like Gullus to do like a 4 or 5-colour deck easily enough. I think like sure, we'll keep it. I think even like playing a 3-colour deck I'm not a fan of here. We'll try to play a 2-colour deck where possible, but because I've got 2 jewels which splash for black and I'm only playing 2 cards, I think that's fine, it's just a little splash. Okay, let's walk out my order down here. I'll say it's a decent one. I am going to fly straight over the top and make it a 0-1. Glass Gasket, okay, nice. We've got a game on our hands now. Island, say go. Play the Arcanist Devil next turn. Probably. Definitely. Definitely not. Land on top. Let's keep a land on top. Staggering inside is actually fine, I think. Yeah. Put that card on the owl. That'll be good. Phyrexian Arena. Nice. They're losing a bit of life though, aren't they? So let's play Hostage Shaker first, and we'll try and take this corpse now. Interesting. Maybe I should try to take this. This is fine though, I'm happy with that. Maybe we're drawing cards at a decent rate though. 5 black mana. Resplendent Angel, nice, okay. If I can have a land, a white land, a plains. It's not a plains. But I can spark double. Hostage Taker. Take the Resplendent Angel. At the very least make them sack an Alcide. No attacks. I would like a plains now though, that would be nice. Sure. Resolves. Gain some life, make some angels. This card's been great. As is this card. Look at that, right on time. You. No attacks. Just gotta find a way to deal with this. I guess next turn we've got Staggering Insight on this one and we'll start attacking. Sigil of the Empty Throne. Wow, okay. Their deck. What is their deck? It's fantastic. So, let's play this. Do I want to play... We'll play this and look for a Glass Casket or a Seal Away. Seal Away is a good one. Corpse Knight here. Play this Corpse Knight. So no attacks. And this is a spark double. This is a Hostage Shaker. Hostage Shaker can block here. And then we'll get it back. I have to jump with the owl sadly, but worse things have happened. I don't think I'm going to win this one at all, but... Oh, wow, Vanishing Light, okay. Yeah, that's good. That's a good one. Getting 4 in the air. +1/+1 counter. I can take this. I can play a planes. I can Staggering Insight on this Hostage Taker. 4/5. Some life, draw a card. happy with that one. And then we'll pass the turn. I'm just going to chump block this knight here. Sure. Resolves. Again for four in the air only. And we're gonna seal away this. Banishing light. What does that do? Does that deal with this at all? I don't think it does. Don't think that does. I think. Plane of cleanse in here. I've got back two cards. What can we find here? Artifact or enchantment. We can find our own glass casket. We can find our prison realm. Yeah, I'm happy with this play. Midnight clock. Okay, we'll do that. That certainly does things here. Dead presence. Cool. Massacre girl. That's a good one. Right. Play this midnight clock first of all. Then we play this Banishing Light, get rid of the Massacre Girl. No attacks. Good trade here. Hypnotic Spectre is a very good one. Yeah, I'm not going to win this. Sure, we'll trade. Temple of Deceit. Swamp to the bottom. Talrand. I don't know, Vanguard. Chumps. Pass the turn. Hopefully they try to play that Kefnet before combat. Not Kefnet, sorry, Ketra. Hopefully they try to play the Ketra before combat. So we can Disdainful Stroke that. And then make a Drake. I liked if they did that, because then we can just trade everything off. Finale of Glory, yeah, yikes. It's a little bit better than a Ketra there. I mean, if they want to trade like that, we'll try that. Certainly do that. I guess we'll go swinging. And 13. Spend this turn pumping as much mana in this as possible. Try to see if we can get Elspeth Conquers Death back. Sure. Try it this. 7, 8. Well, it's not a land. It is not a land. Quite happy with that one, actually. No attacks. Off we go. It's a shame we can't pump it, but... I mean, there's no trample there. We just do this now then? I'll draw 7 cards. Look at that, perfect. Perfect. Right. So we can place Isolated Chapel first. Pump this. We have 3 mana available after that. That's probably not going to be enough. Get rid of the Ketra first of all. And then this Kunaros wheel attack with everything. See the trade with Torrent? No, they didn't. Cool. And I think I've done quite well to bring this back if I do somehow pull this off. Your next turn's very easy, just pump the Angel. Angel is not there, so we don't pump the Angel. I'll take that back. Do that first of all then. For 5 damage, I can bring the Angel back while Elspeth conquers death, so I'm happy with that. Yeah, sure. Sure, I'm happy. Do I have to play a creature or a way to kill the Kunaros? Kunaros? I'm not sure how you pronounce that name. It's a cool card though. Very cool card. It's a shame it's not good enough for standard. Cauldron's Gift. Yeah, we'll disdainful stroke that. And we'll say good game. And there we go. We have it. We have it. The 5-0. Fantastic. Yeah, dead happy with that. GG. Easy. Nice 5-0. Fantastic. 600 gems, 3 cards, we can jump straight back in. Yeah, great. Also, thanks for joining me on this. I hope you enjoyed that. I'm very happy with how that went. It was great fun. If you want to see more videos like this, please hit subscribe below, leave the video a like, it really helps out. You can also find me at the links you can see on your screen, right there. So, yeah, once again, thanks for joining me, check me out in these places here, and I'll see you on the internet.